Tonight on EA Sports, Super Bowl 59. Taking on the Houston Texans.
It's the National Football League presented by EA Sports. We count down to kickoff in what should be an epic one here, as it'll be the AFC champion Houston Texans taking on the champions from the NFC, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. It's finally time for the main event here in 2025. Away we go in Super Bowl 59. And we will not have a return, so the first drive of this Super Bowl will begin at the 25. So out come the Bucs now for their first drive. And they will be led out by a guy certainly still trying to prove himself here in the league, the young rookie quarterback.
And as we know and as we've discussed here in the run-up to this game, this is history in the making. The first rookie quarterback to ever start in a Super Bowl. An absolutely tremendous accomplishment, something no one else has done. But he doesn't want to just go down as the first to make a Super Bowl. He's told us all week he's here to win it.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 11 yards there on the first play from scrimmage. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Back to throw. That's caught by his tight end, Evan Engram. And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Eluding the... And he's taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack. Danico Autry able to run him down for a loss of 12 that time. Looking to throw. Buying time. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. T.J. Watt, he's the one that drops him this go-around, and that pass rush getting strong here, back-to-back sacks. Now on third and forever, he'll look to throw. Under pressure, and they got to him again. Danico Autry, that's now back-to-back sacks, and it brings up fourth down. So on fourth down, on is the punter, Ryan Wright. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. This is taken at the 15. A very good return there. Give him an even 20 yards. And the Texans will take over with a first and 10. So out come the Texans for their opening drive. And they will be led out by their second-year quarterback.
And there are a lot of quarterbacks who had terrific careers. Think about guys like Phillip Rivers, Randall Cunningham, Dan Fouts, Warren Moon, but they never got to a Super Bowl. Yet here he is in his second NFL season, already getting his chance. And we harken back to Dan Marino, another superstar, made it in his second year, lost the game, and never made it back again.
Oh, he's going to air it out right away. Throw it across his body, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Darnell Savage. A young quarterback, Charles, rolling to his right. I know he's right-handed, but is that one that maybe a veteran sticks in his pocket?
I think so, but you have to remember, with young quarterbacks, it may take a few years before they get all the stuff out of them that they did earlier in their career or even in their college days when they were used to being dominant. In this case, the NFL veteran defense ended up winning the battle.
On second down, they'll run it here. Oh, and he's not going to make it out of the end zone. The push too strong, and that'll be a safety. Well, you talk about safety first. Gosh, for such a rare play, kind of unbelievable how many Super Bowls recently have begun with a safety. Charles, you had, let's see, Tom Brady getting called for grounding against the Giants in Super Bowl 46.
Peyton Manning with the snap over his head in Super Bowl 48.
Yep, and now here's this one. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. For this offense, Charles, you got to think kind of crucial here to put something together on this drive, because remember last time out, they threw the interception on the very first play.
And you can't afford to let this defense keep building any more momentum. They're playing awfully well, and they're awfully confident right now. To me, it's time to attack and take some of that momentum back. But make sure you're selective in doing so. Understand where you want to throw the football and make sure it's open before the ball leaves your hands.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. They'll roll him out right. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down. On third down, they're going to run for it here. And he is going to have a Texans first down as they're able to convert, albeit not by much, on third and a yard. Rolling to his left. And that is caught. Touchdown, Texans. DeAndre Hopkins, 30 yards. And they are able to add on to their advantage. Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and that makes this a 9-point game. Five plays there on that drive, and it's finished off by the touchdown from DeAndre Hopkins. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. They trail early on in this Super Bowl as they come up first and 10. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down. Hands it off out of the gun. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. After one, it's 9-0. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. And we are back. Biggest game of the year, the Super Bowl, and both teams ready for the start of the second quarter. And unable to connect. Incomplete. I'll give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down. On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. Oh, he'll field it in the end zone. And he's going to be trapped inside his own five. A very curious decision to bring that one out. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And they will start this drive with just terrible field position, backed up inside their own five.
But we have seen teams be bold here and take shots, right? Sometimes you go max protection, make it a one receiver route and take your shot downfield and see what happens. And occasionally, we've seen success occur.
Second and four, being chased out left. Now he'll square up and throw deep left sideline. And that is incomplete. Now they face a third down and four after that incompletion on second down. They'll look to throw here. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. Again, he'll drop to throw. It's caught by Mike Evans. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. Getting it to him in space pays off big time. That winds up going for 31.
Running their plays over and over during the week can often get robotic for an offense, but on game day, they can often flow smoothly, as that one just did.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. A quick throw knocked away and incomplete. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Back to throw again. And this is caught by Evans. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 24-yard line. They go play action here on first down. On the move to his left. And that one going to be off target and incomplete.
Yeah, their back's up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
That is caught. Hopkins for the Texans touchdown. DeAndre Hopkins, his second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Texans continue to look good here in the first half of this Super Bowl. Tucker with the extra point, and that could be important as that makes this a 16-point lead. Tucker now following the made field goal, set to kick it away. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They're down a couple of scores, 16-0, as they start things out with a first and 10. Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Trayvon Diggs. And the Texans are going to take possession of the football. He's had a fantastic rookie season, made a lot of lovely throws, but that wasn't one of them.
Well, we got to give him one, don't we? I mean, with the year he's having, a lot easier for he and his teammates to accept that throw, because for the most part, what they've seen, it's been pretty sensational. And to put it mildly, this is a tough spot defensively. They have to come right back out and defend their red zone. But how about that good first step towards forcing them to settle for at least 3 points? I think they're also thinking bigger right now. Imagine being able to stop them totally and change the momentum.
That's so close. He gets it to the one. Out of bounds right there. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's in for the score. Touchdown, Texans. Taking it in from a yard out. And the Texans are starting to open things up here in this Super Bowl. Tucker able to connect on the extra point. And that pushes the lead up to 23. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And we don't want to call this desperation time, especially in the second quarter, but you're
down.
You
don't want to.
This time for Smith, and it's intercepted. It's Devin White, the linebacker. And they will score a pick six for the Texans TD. Well, this defense, they've been terrific all year, and they come through with a pick six here on the game's biggest stage.
Perfect descriptor there, because we have seen this time and time again. This defense, their ability to take the ball away from teams, they definitely have a nose for the football, and it pays off again on that play.
Tucker with the extra point, and the rout is on here in this first half. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback. That pick six just a moment ago, things went from bad to worse. Look up at the scoreboard now. Not looking good here. We'll see if they can put something together on this drive. First and 10. After the pick six, they go right back to the air. Finds his tight end, Ingram. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. They'll set up to throw. That's complete to Justin Jefferson. He was a 1,000-yard receiver during the regular season, and that's his first catch of this Super Bowl, and he picks up the first down. It's been a very one-sided game so far. They got to change what they're doing right now, don't they? You can't wait till the halftime speech to make an adjustment.
No, you can't, because if you're doing it right, you're adjusting from series to series, and they need a big adjustment here to try and put some points on the board.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. They're going to look to throw. They'll complete this to Ingram, his tight end. They're going to need to get up and set in a hurry. They'll look to throw again. Throw left side, taken in by Jefferson. And he's out of bounds just before the midfield stripe at the 49. That's now 4 completions in a row. A good bounce back following the interception last drive.
Certainly not letting it affect him, that's for sure. And we all know interceptions are going to happen. So the big trick, don't let it affect you going forward. Most of the good quarterbacks, they just tell the ball boy, get that one out of the rotation, give me a fresh ball, and let's go. He's got his offense moving again.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he'll be taken down here just shy of the 30. Now a second down and 6. Back to throw here. He gets this one complete to Tre'Quan Smith. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. They'll drop to throw. This one brought in by Jefferson. Now another timeout called for by the offense. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. Second and 3. Complete. Smith has it. 6 yards on the pickup, and it leaves him with a first and goal. He'll look to throw. Now, quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete. They'll go again here from the 10-yard line on second and goal. They'll set up a throw. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. Another shot to at least get on the board here. This is third and goal. And this is going to be intercepted. And the Texans force the turnover. They'll take over at their own 27. And the defense, Charles, they bent a little bit, but they did not break. And then on third and goal there, the huge interception.
Think of the momentum they're carrying with them right now, Brandon, because in their mind, whether they want to admit it or not, they were conceding 3 points. Their goal was to keep them out of the end zone, not give up a touchdown. Instead, they give up nothing. What a big-time play and a big-time stop by them.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. What a season this has been. Hard to believe it ends tonight, as we'll get back to you guys for the second half of this Super Bowl in just a moment. Thus far, this Super Bowl has looked less like a contest and more like a coronation. And to call the second half, let's get it right back out to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. These two teams sat through a longer than usual 30-minute wait, but we're back in action here in this Super Bowl. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped it to 23. But the Texans getting ready to go here to begin the third quarter. And I would imagine this is where you have to take stock of the situation, CD, and say, gosh, we're halfway to the Lombardi Trophy. Let's not slow down now.
And I like the way you went there. Let's not slow down now, because the first half certainly went their way.
He's got a man complete. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And it is incomplete. Good positioning there downfield to break that one up. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. They'll look to throw. Dancing to his left. And he fires one incomplete.
Barton, I think he's got to be careful as he continues to try to extend plays, because he's already been intercepted in this game. And the coverage, they continue to challenge all of his receivers downfield.
And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. And Tucker, the former Longhorn, puts this one through. And that will extend their lead even further. Well, they picked up right where they left off in the first half. First drive after the break, they come away with three and increase that lead.
Yeah, and you just want to keep building on that lead, don't you? Whether it's 6 points or 3 points, take everything you can get, keep maneuvering, keep adding to it, keep making it difficult for them to come back.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. To throw now on first down. Over the middle to Smith. And this winds up a gain of four to the 41. Second and six. He'll look to throw. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. Give him a gain of five on the completion. And third and one now. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And Ingram hauls it in. And he's going to be taken down right at the 40-yard line.
He's certainly done a nice job spreading the field on this drive. And here he finds his big tight end for good yardage. And that's what you have to do. Keep defenses guessing about where you're going to go with the football.
They'll look to throw now on first down. He targets Ingram for another grab. And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of five. Second and five. Throwing middle, and it's complete. And he's going to be taken down with another first down as the stop's made at the Texans 21. He'll drop to throw. To the right side and complete to Jefferson. And they've got this down to about the 12-yard line. Second and one. Over the middle, he's got his tight end, Ingram. And the Bucs are looking at first and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line. Now back to throw. And he hauls it in for the Buccaneer touchdown. A 2-yard touchdown grab. And the Bucs get a bit closer. Myers connects on the PAT, and that trims the lead a bit, but still standing at 26 points. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. Taken at the goal line. And he'll be brought down at the 28-yard line, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone gets him three more. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. Still comfortably on top, third quarter, as they start things here with a first. And a diving effort, but only right at the line of scrimmage. A lot of effort there for just a 3-yard gain, and now second down. Almost time for the final act of this NFL season, as we are now through three quarters in the Super Bowl. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. And the defense closes quickly there. He'll get maybe a yard to the 33. The offense on third down tonight, they've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. Steps away to his left. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. The decision to tuck and run gets him 3, but that's not enough. Now it's 4th.
No surprise to see him running again here. It's something he's done throughout this season. And that run puts him over 500 yards on the ground for the year. He's got to be thinking to himself, if I'm already at 500, what's to stop me from going for 1,000?
And a nice job here to down this one right on the 5-yard line.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. A pass there over the middle to start things out. Short completion, just 4 yards, and it's 2nd down. Toss left side into the hands of his tight end. And out of bounds across the 15-yard line. On first down, he'll drop to throw. Open man right side is Ingram. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch. And it'll be 2nd down. Back to throw. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he's able to get up here to the 26. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, 2nd and 10. Now a dump off here complete. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a 3rd down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
On 3rd down, he'll drop to throw. The pass complete to Ingram on the crossing route. And he is going to have the Buccaneers 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the 4th quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. They've got a 1st and 10 as they search for a late score. They'll look to throw here on 1st down. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. After the incomplete pass here now is 2nd and 10. looking to throw.
Throw over the middle, taken in by Dulcich.
And he's going to be taken down with another first down as the stop's made at the Texans 36. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he'll be brought down at the 27. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set. Now a man open down the middle of the field. And they're going to move it down inside the 25. They're going to hurry back to the line now. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete. So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down. Again, he'll drop to throw. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he's brought down inside the 20 at the 18-yard line. Got an open man finding Jefferson. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. They'll look to throw here. That's complete right around the 8. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they get it with 26 seconds to go in the football game. From the 7, it's 2nd and 5. Back to throw again. And it's complete right back in the hands of Smith. So give him 2 yards there on the completion. And that'll bring us to a 3rd and 4. And we will get a timeout with 2 ticks left.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route. And he ran it a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line. But once he made...
And for the 4th time tonight, it's an interception. It's Devin White, the linebacker. Defenders giving chase, but I don't think they're going to get there. The 20. And they will score a pick 6 for the Texans TD.
Well, what has been a fantastic game for this defense has been rough for this offense. And certainly a signal caller, Charles, that's thrown all these interceptions. Another one there, and this one taken all the way back for the score.
Partner hoping they're holding a nice little spot in the post-game highlights to show this rip of interceptions and great plays this group has made. They've been on it from snap 1.
And the Lone Star State has a new champion. It's the Houston Texans, kings of the Super Bowl. And when this moment comes, I think you look back at all the blood, sweat, and tears, the offseason, the workouts, training camp, week 1, 2, 3, all building up now to say you're a Super Bowl champion. It's worth it.
It certainly is, and rarely do we have a team that hoists the Lombardi Trophy that didn't have their share of bumps along the way, didn't have to face some adversity in the journey, and now they get to just enjoy it and revel in it. And all offseason, they'll be signing their autographs with Super Bowl champion underneath it.
And they end this year just how everybody wants to end the year, holding the Lombardi Trophy. What a season for them. What a ride it's been for us as well here in the booth. For Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gunn. Thanks for watching, everybody. We will see you next season right here on EA Sports.